New South Wales has recorded its best run of case numbers in more than 2 months. And while southwest Sydney remains a concern, the Premier today ruled out testing door to door.
Riding the COVID roller coaster, and the Premier today was up.
Pleasingly, in New South Wales, we had 5 cases of COVID overnight.
And then she was down.
At least a case a day, which we can't directly or immediately link.
Today's results significant. 7 straight days of single-digit numbers. Of the 5 new cases, 2 are returned travellers in hotel quarantine. The remaining 3 popped up in the city's hottest hotspot.
We're still obviously concerned about what is transpiring in southwestern Sydney.
And the darker the green on the health department's heat map, the more active cases in that postcode. There is Ndenza Park and Bosley Park with 21. Further south, there's Cabramatta and Canley Heights, where there are 10 cases. And Ayres, Ambervale and Appin have 12 active cases.
The health official's response is to get tested, but in one of the danger zones, Bankstown, today there were very few takers at the local drive-through clinic. To ramp up numbers in Victoria, suburbs were tested en masse, with health workers going from door to door. But Premier Berejiklian says that strategy will never be adopted here.
Random testing doesn't work.
And also doomed, the NRL's latest bid to have a 50,000-strong crowd at the grand final.
We allow up to 10,000 at a sporting venue. I think that is a pretty good balance at this stage.
Damien Ryan, Nine News.
Victoria's virus numbers are stabilising. 240 new infections today, but sadly 13 more people have died. The mistakes that fuelled the crisis were in sharp focus today. An inquiry hearing of chaotic and risky practices inside hotel quarantine.
Nurses and returned travellers. Today, a look inside Melbourne's COVID hotel quarantine.
It was very chaotic.
You spent 14 days at the Crown Metropole.
Yes.
No one ever offered you a test?
No.
Evidence of shambolic record keeping, risking cross-contamination in elevators.
Were people using PPE appropriately as far as you were concerned?
No, definitely not. I saw a lot of security guards, for example, constantly wearing the same gloves throughout their shifts, going and making themselves a coffee with gloves on, using their phone, things like that.
I saw security guards with their masks down underneath their chin, eating their lunch with gloves on.
Nurse Michael Tate claims he had to do his own research on how to swab specifically for COVID-19.
You'd attended this job expecting that you would be swabbing people. There were no swab kits, only 3 gowns and a small number of masks.
Correct.
Right now, Victoria has more than 4,800 people with COVID-19. The inquiry has already heard 99% of those can be traced back to breaches in hotel quarantine. Human rights lawyer Hugh de Kretser and his family travelling home from the USA were housed at the Ridges on Swanston, where most of Melbourne's second outbreak was spawned.
We were nervous for our safety, and then we saw the state of the rooms, which we were shocked at how unclean they were.
Making a record, a stray rubber glove, a children's toy left behind, and food on the floor, a potentially contaminated face mask, and stains on the bed linen. Lizzie Pearl, Nine News.